for the reason that the education given to him never proved useful and that he is now good for nothing. He demands that he be re-examined in all the subjects so that he can prove that he is right. Does he succeed in his mission? Ladies and gentlemen, sit back and enjoy this light and rollicking play and find out yourselves. Over to the play, Refund.
A man, sir, outside. He wants to see you.
I receive parents only during office hours. The particular office hours are posted on the notice board. Go tell him that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But it's not a parent, sir.
A pupil?
I don't think so. He has a beard.
Not a parent and not a pupil, huh? Then who is he?
He just told me I should send it with.
What does he look like? Stupid? Intelligent?
Fairly intelligent, I'd say, sir.
Good. Then he's not a school inspector. Show him in.
Yes, sir.
How do you do?
What can I do for you?
I'm Nitwit. Don't you remember me?
No.
It's possible I've changed. What the hell? Your class records will show I've got a right to come here.
The class records? How so?
Mr. Principal, if you please, I'm Nitwit.
Doubtless, doubtless. But what has that to do with it?
You mean to say you don't even remember my name? No, I imagine you wouldn't. You were probably glad to forget me. Well, Mr. Principal, I was a student of the school 18 years ago.
Oh, were you? Well, what do you want now? A certificate?
Since I'm bringing back the leaving certificate you gave me, I suppose I can get along without another one. No, that isn't why I came here.
Well?
As a former pupil of the school, I want you to refund the tuition fees that were paid to you for my education 18 years ago.
You want me to refund your tuition fees?
Exactly. If I were a rich man, I'd ask you to keep them. So far as I'm concerned, what the hell? I'm not a rich man and I need the money.
I'm not quite sure I understand.
Damn it, I want my tuition fees back. Is that plain enough?
Why do you want it back?
Because I didn't get my money's worth. This certificate here says I got an education. Well, I didn't. I didn't learn anything and I need my money.
But really, look here, I've never heard of anything like it. I don't understand it at all. Such an absurd idea.
Absurd, is it?
Yes.
It's a good idea. It's such a good idea that I didn't get it out of my own head. Thanks to the education I got here.
Which made nothing but an incompetent ass out of me. My old friend Ledra gave me the idea, not half an hour ago.
Gave it to you?
Like that.
Hey.
Wait.
Here, I was walking along the street, fired from my last job, and wondering how I could get hold of some cash. I met Ledra. How goes it, Ledra? I asked. Fine, he says. I've made money in foreign exchange. What's foreign exchange? I asked. He says, Nitwit, if you don't know that, you don't know a damn thing. Go back to your school and get your tuition fees back. So here I am.
Well, but Ledra told you.
He's a good friend, Ledra. He told me. And when I get my tuition fees back, I'm going to buy him a present.
You! You're not really serious, are you?
I was never more serious in my life. You treat me wrong here and I'll go straight to the Ministry of Education and complain about you. You took my money and you taught me nothing. Now, I'm no good for anything. And anybody can see I ought to have my money back.
You're mad! My dear sir, Mr. Nitwit, please go away quietly. I'll think the matter over and get back to you as soon as I can.
No, no. You don't get rid of me so easy. I'll go when everything's been settled. I was given instructions here in exchange for money so that I might be able to do something. Well, I can't do anything and I need my money.
Well, what makes you think you can't do anything?
Everybody thinks so. If I get a job, I can't keep it. Give me an examination and tell me what I have to do. Call in the masters and let them say.
What a distressing business. How unfortunate. You really want a re-examination?
Yes. I have a right to take one.
Such a confusing case. I shall have to consult the staff and call in a meeting. Will you please wait in the waiting room and give me a few minutes?
Yes, be quick. I've got no time to waste.
Yes, sir.
Ask the staff to come here at once. A most extraordinary conference.
Yes, sir.
Come in, gentlemen. Gentlemen, I have asked you to come here on account of a most unusual state of affairs. Sit down, gentlemen. I shall open the conference. It is unprecedented, incredible and fantastic. A former pupil by the name Nitwit has come to see me, and he has brought up a question which I've never encountered in my many years of experience. I've never heard of anything like it.
Tell us about it.
He wants his tuition fees back.
Why?
Because he's lost his job. Because he's an ass. Because he's broke. I should like to have you gentlemen express your views on this unparalleled case.
The case is natural. The law of conservation of energy proves that any given student will lose in any given period as much knowledge as a teacher can drill into his head in another period of like duration.
There is nothing like it in the history of civilization. It is said that the Bourbons learned nothing and forgot nothing. And if that is true...
No. The law of conservation of energy.
The question is, does he want his money back in simple or compound interest? Because in the latter event...
Where is that fellow anyhow?
He is waiting outside. He says he's learned nothing and he wants a re-examination. He believes a re-examination will prove it. I should like to know what you gentlemen think of it.
A re-examination? Gentlemen, it is my conviction that we will lose nothing by re-examining Mr. Nitwit. Because if he fails, he'll place us in an awkward situation. We will not make our questions too difficult. Agreed, gentlemen?
Agreed.
We are dealing with a sly, crafty individual who'll try to take the better of us and get his money back by hook or crook. We must checkmate him.
But how?
By sticking together. No, not literally. The object is to prevent him from failing. Because if he fails, he succeeds. And if he succeeds, tomorrow we'll have two more former pupils. And the next day, a dozen. That we must stop. We must not let this painful affair turn into a pedagogical scandal. We will ask him questions, and whatever he answers, we agree beforehand that they are correct.
But who will decide?
I, if you permit me. Mr. Principal, let us carry on with the examination. We will show the former pupil that we too can be shrewd.
But isn't there a chance of something going wrong? Suppose it gets into the newspapers.
Leave it to us.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Please show in Mr. Nitwit.
Yes, sir.
How do you do?
Who the hell are you? Sit down, you loafers.
How dare you?
Please, sit down, you loafers. My dear sir, the greeting you have just given us shows us that you accept of the patriarchal manners which we impress upon everybody in this institution. I am sure my colleagues will agree that you need not be examined in what appears to be gentlemanliness and be marked excellent in that subject.
Quite right. Manners, excellent.
Agreed.
All right, if you say so. What the hell? I don't give a damn for the lot of you. My being gentlemanly isn't going to pass the examination. So let me fail as quickly as possible and refund my tuition fees.
Speaking for the staff, your exquisite courtesy will not harm us one way or the other. We will examine you and will be guided by your answers to our questions only. Take notice of that.
All right. Ask me questions. I need money. Go to it. Ask me questions, professors. I mean, long-eared asses. I'd like to see you get a single correct answer out of me.
The examination will begin. History, Mr. Muddlehead?
Mr. Nitwit, won't you be seated?
To hell with the seat. I'll stand.
Bravo, excellent. Mr. Nitwit here wishes us to understand two things. He will dispense of a formal written examination and answer early. He will stand, also good. It shows us that his physical culture is great. I ask the principal who teaches that subject to concur.
Quite right. Physical culture, very good.
Agreed.
No. You caught me once, didn't you? Well, you won't do that again. I'll have my ears open.
Alertness, very good.
Perseverance, unusual.
Logic, excellent.
Get on with your questions.
Ambition,
boundless.
Yes, just a minute.
What's the matter, Muddlehead? Aren't you prepared?
A moment.
Oh, you can't think of a question that's too easy enough. You were always a numbskull.
Candidate, answer this question. How long did the 30 years war last?
I don't know.
Please answer my question. I'm sure you know. Give me the answer.
30 years.
Well, Mr. Principal, this is no way to run an examination. This fellow here is trying to make me cheat.
I shall deal with this decisively. Sit down, I say.
How long did the 30 years war last? Wasn't that the question?
Yes, yes.
I know. 7 meters long. That's the answer. 7 meters.
7 meters? Right. Your answer is excellent.
What? What did you say?
The answer is correct. As a matter of fact, the candidate here has shown us that his thought processes are not merely superficial, and that he has investigated in this subject in accordance with modern researches based on
relativity, of course. Planck, Einstein, it's all very simple. My dear sir, you need not say another word. If you reduce a mass system to a unit, a year can be represented by a meter and 7 years by 7 meters. We can also assume that the 30 years war lasted only 7 years because
the actual warfare took place only during half of each day. That is to say 12 hours out of 24. So the 30 years at once became 15. But not even 15 years were given up for incessant fighting, for the combatants had to eat 3 hours a day, reducing our 15 years to 12. And if we deduct from this the hours given up for noonday siestas, to peaceful diversions, to non-warlike activities,
to social distractions, we are left only with time, which the candidate has represented in the Einsteinian equivalent of 7 meters. My gentlemen, I take it upon myself to propose a grading of very good in history to Mr. Nitwit.
Bravo! Oh, excellent! Yes, pass!
But I don't see
that ends the examination in history. History, very good! Now, the examination in physics.
Now we'll see something, you tricksters.
Come.
Well, what's gonna happen? Ask your questions or don't. I've got no time to waste. Oh, now I remember you. Do you know what we used to call you behind your back? We used to call you cannibal because you were always chewing your thumb, just as you're doing now. And do you remember the day you tripped and fell down the aisle? Do you know who tied a string across from desk to desk so you'd do that? I did it.
You?
Don't get excited, little man. Ask me a tough question instead. Plow me.
Kind of you. Very kind of you. And now, tell me, Mr. Nitwit, do clocks really become smaller as you walk away from them? Or merely appear to become smaller because of an optical illusion?
What an absolute rot. How should I know? Whenever I walk away from the clock, they get larger invariably. And if I want them to get smaller, I turn towards them and walk up to them. And they're not small at all.
In a word, therefore,
you give me a pain in the neck. You're an ass, that's my answer.
Is that your answer?
Yes.
Good, it is correct. A difficult answer, but a most brilliant one. I'll explain. When we talk of an ass, we always notice.
Yes.
That his look is sad, and therefore I've got it.
What have you got, you whiskered baboon?
I've got it, and the answer is right. Why is the look of an ass so sad? Because we're all the victims of illusion, the illusion of senses. For the ass lacks imagination, and the ass like us observe that object appear to become smaller as you walk away from them. The answer was correct. I certify, therefore, that the candidate must be given very good in physics.
Quite right. Physics, very good.
Bravo.
Bravo, excellent.
I protest. Now the examination in geography.
Just look at him, the old hypocrite. How are you anyhow, Timwit?
I beg your pardon.
My name used to be in our class books, didn't it? You old reprobate. Just wait till I fix you all right.
Tell me, candidate.
Oh, I'll tell you how I used to hate you 18 years ago.
Please tell me, what city of the same name is the capital of German province of Brunswick?
What a dumb question. The answer is part of the question.
Isn't it? And the answer, what is it?
Same, of course. If the name of the city is same, then the name of the city is same, isn't it? Well, if it isn't, I fail. And you refund my tuition fees.
Yes, the answer is excellent. The candidate's answer is excellent. Gentlemen, the candidate's answer is excellent. There is a legend that once, as Emperor Barbarossa was riding into a city, he met a young peasant girl munching on a bun whose mouth was full. He called out to her, "God bless you, what is the name of the city?" And the young peasant girl replied, "Same to you." And suddenly she stopped because her mouth was full. Then the king laughed and said, "Ho, ho, so the name of the city is same." Candidate's answer is excellent. The candidate is entitled Excellent grade in geography.
Geography. Excellent. Thus far, the candidate has come through with flying colors. Now, only the examination in mathematics is left. Should he pass that, he will have passed the entire examination.
I'll be more careful now. So here you are, you old stick in the mud. Do you know who used to call you old stick in the mud behind your back? You better brush up your wits if you think you're going to put one over me. I'll start off by telling you a few things about mathematics. 2 times 2 is 5. And I make up my own multiplication table as I go along. And if you add 8 apples and 2 pears, the answer is 27 apricots. That's my system. And you'll see me use it. To hell with mathematics. Answer, excellent. Answer, correct. Answer, very good. Not this time. It'll be simpler if you say you aren't prepared and let me fail.
You must not joke about a serious examination. I will ask you 2 questions. One of them is easy and the other is hard.
One of them is easy and the other is hard. The same old stick in the mud that you always were.
So here's my easy question. If you represent the speed of light by x and the distance from the sun to star Sirius by y, what is the circumference of a 109-sided polyhedron whose surface area coincides with that of a hip pocket of a state railway employee whose wife has been deceiving him for 2 years and 11 months with a sergeant major?
Professor!
Please, don't interfere with him. Will you repeat the question?
No, either you paid attention or you haven't. Either you know the answer or you don't. Because if you don't know...
Of course I know the answer. Naturally I know the answer. The answer is 2629 liters. Exact. No fractions. And did I give you the correct answer? Ha! I've given you an answer which is too good.
No. The correct answer is 2628 liters and not 29. Mr. Principal, I refuse to pass the candidate. Mark him failure.
I told you so.
Professor!
I'm sorry. The candidate's answer amounted to less than a tenth of a percent of the correct answer. But an error is an error. He fails.
That's so. That's right. Give me my money.
Is that what you think?
Yes, absolutely. This is a good school. It is our duty to see that nothing ever injures its reputation. How much do we owe you, Mr. Nitwit?
I've come well prepared with the figures. I'll tell you exactly. I attended this school for 6 years in all. During the first 3 years, the fees was 150 rupees quarterly. Total, 1800 rupees. And during the second 3 years, the fees was 400 rupees semi-annually. Total, 1800 and 2400 is 4200 rupees. And examination fees, 250 rupees, 95 paise. Certificates, documents, books, stamp taxes, 1241 rupees, 43 paise. Total, 5682 rupees, 38 paise. Incidentals, stationery, notebooks, 786 rupees, 12 paise. Grand total, 6,450 rupees, 50 paise. And if you add the interest of the 18 years, it sums up to 60,000 rupees, 95 paise. Knock off the paise and call it rupees.
Exactly.
You can rely on it.
I congratulate you. That was my second question and the difficult one.
What?
Mr. Principal, his answer to the easy question was a little out of the way, but his answer to the difficult question, how much the refund should be, was exactly right, to the smallest detail. Mr. Nitwit is a mathematical genius.
So you did put one over me.
I present the results of the examination. Mr. Nitwit here has shown once again that he is entitled to the certificate that we gave him 18 years ago on his graduation. We offer our congratulations to you, Nitwit, accepting a large share of them ourselves for having taught you so excellently. And now that we have verified your knowledge and your abilities, get out before I have you thrown out!
So, I am a numbskull, am I? Say it again and I'll show you what is what.
I'm a cannibal, huh? And you were the one who tied a string across the aisle?
Hypocrite, dimwit, ass and me?
Old stick in the mud.
Throw that object out! Thank you, gentlemen, for your magnificent cooperation. In the future, it'll be our proudest boast that a student of the school simply cannot fail.
May I now introduce you to the cast of the play? Mr. Nitwit, Mohammed Mehraz of class 10. Principal Mr. Noel is Shashank Kashyap of class 10. The mathematics teacher, Ankit A of class 10. Physics teacher, Ankit Raj of class 9. History teacher, Vishnu Dinesh of class 9. Geography teacher, Niranjan of class 9. And last but not the least, the office boy, Drupad of class 9. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.